Hello everyone. So in the last class we have discussed about how to design as well as calculate the load of a RCC rectangular tank as per Indian Standard Cudel provision IS 3370 part 1, part 2 and part 4. But there are some other methods, approximate method available for designing of a rectangular water tank. So today we are going to discuss such one kind of design of a such kind of a method where we will not be using the IS 3370 part 4 for calculation of the moments and shear force, but instead we are going to use our conventional knowledge about water pressure in a water tank, and then we will design as per IS 3370 part 2. So here let us first look at the problem. The problem statement is: design a rectangular water tank to store 40 kiloliter of water, and you have means only this value is given to you. It has to store 40,000 liters of water. Okay, so for this, let us first try to find out what is the volume of or the dimension of the water tank that will be required for our particular design. So for that, first of all, let us assume that the height or the depth of the water tank is 3 meters, just an assumption. Then the volume of the water tank is given as 40,000 liters. So if I convert it to in meter cube, because we already know that 1000 liter is equal to 1 meter cube, so if I want to convert it to this liter to meter cube, so I have to divide it by 1000, it becomes 40 meter cube. Okay, so the cross section area of the tank becomes volume of the tank divided by the height, and which comes out to be 13.33 meters square. This is the cross sectional area. So let us assume that one side or the one side of the water tank is of width B is equal to 30 meter, and then we can find out what is the other side, because A by B is equal to 4.44 meter. So from those calculations we can roughly assume a particular volume of a rectangular tank which has the dimensions something like this, where this is 3 meter and this is 5 meter. This is the length and this is the width, and the height, the height is 3 meter. Okay, the height, if we are talking about, then it is 3 meter. The height is 3 meter. So this is the water tank that we need to design, because it will be able to take a volume of 40,000 liters. Fine. So first, then we can assume what is the grade of steel and grade of concrete that we're going to use. Probably in the previous class I have already told you that what is the minimum grade of concrete that we can use for different rectangular for different concrete water retaining structures. But for in this case we are going to assume that the FCK is 25 and FY is 415 MPa, so this HYSD bar. Okay, so this two type of material grade we are going to use for our design. Now the first thing that we need to calculate is the moment. You already know about this. The load calculation is the most important part, moment and shear force. But for moment and shear force, the okay, first let us talk about the moment. So as you can see in a water tank, a rectangular water tank, so suppose this is a water tank and it is filled with water, then because of the Pascal's law, or you can say this is the nature of the water, that it will exert equal pressure on all the four sides of the wall, right? Something like this. So because of this, the wall will have a deformation, because it's a fixed end, so it will have a deformation something like this. I think yellow color is not very visible, so it will have a deformation something like this. Okay, it will have a deformation something like this. So in the previous class, basically we have designed this particular wall. Okay, we have only designed the wall, and because depending upon the deformation and the loaded that are coming, we have calculated the shear force and moment as per IS 3370 part 4. But for this case also, the behavior of the water tank is not going to change. Our approach is going to change, but the behavior is not going to change for the water tank, because the water tank will not change his behavior, its behavior, depending upon the method you are going to use, right? So the behavior is the same. Now it has been found that the, or you can say approximately, the moment at the support can be written as it is WL square by 12, and at the midspan it is WL square by 16. So these are the basically the values of the moments that you can find out at the end as well as at the midspan of the beam, of the wall section. So let me first confirm it. Yeah, this true, this correct. Now okay, now here you can see that we need the length of the water tank. We need the length of the water tank. So the length, you can refer to it as the effective length. So the effective length, for finding out the effective length, we already know it should be the clear span plus the effective depth, right? So this is the effective length for this water tank. So in that case, we just need to find out what is the effective depth. That means we need the thickness of the wall. So that is why the first thing that we are going to calculate is the thickness of the wall. What should be the thickness of the wall? So there is no such like hard and fast rule what should be the thickness, but only basic criteria is that it should be able to take the stresses without cracking, and obviously there should not be more serviceability requirement. There should not be very there should not be deflection, noticeable deflection. There should not be noticeable deflection. So these two criteria should be fulfilled. So there are certain empirical, you can say, thumb rules that are, which are provided in certain books. So one of the thing is that the minimum width or the thickness of the wall should be 150 mm. Then the width can be also find out from 3 cm per meter depth plus 5 cm, or in mm you can write is 30 mm per meter depth plus 550 mm. So it becomes the depth we have is 3 meters, so 3 3s are 90 plus 5, so it is 140 mm. And there is another thumb rule, that is 6 per meter length of the side. So length we have 5 meter, the 6 centimeter is 60 mm into 5, so it is 300 mm. So out of this 3, whatever you find to be the greatest, you took that value. So it is 150, 140 and 130, sorry, 300. So we'll stick to the thickness of the wall as 300 mm. Now so this is we have assumed. So now let us find out what is the effective span. So it is your length that is clear span plus the wall thickness, that is 5.3. Always remember that that whatever dimensions we are finding out, that is internal to internal dimension, because you can see that our criteria is the it should be able to take the water, and the volume of water will be inside the water tank. So this is 5 meter basically. This is 5 meter, but if you consider the thickness, so obviously the thickness or the actual outer to outer dimension of the water tank will be more. So that is why I have directly taken L as 5 meter, because it's the center to center distance or the clear span plus the thickness of the wall as 5.3 meters. So we have not gone for finding out the effective depth yet. You can do that, but it is not going to affect much of this. But and also taking a larger value of effective length will in turn will give you an higher moment, so it will be in the safer side. So it will be in the safer side. Now the effective length found out to be is 5.3 meters, and the unit weight of water is 9.81 kilonewton per meter cube. You already know about this. Now from the design point of view, it has been assumed that suppose this is the water tank, the 3D view of the water tank. So generally it is assumed that for the last 1 meter height, the last bottom 1 meter height is assumed to be have undergone the cantilever effect. Means you can see that walls are basically experiencing the force in the outward direction. So obviously there will be basically, and also the ends of the walls are being fixed to the other sides. So it will be having a combined effect of bending as well as the cantilever effect, the beam effect as well as the cantilever effect, both effect you can see, because from if you're looking from the base, the wall is coming outward, so it is just like a cantilever attached to this base. You can see this is just a cantilever which is attached to the base. And also if you consider the end, these two sides, then you can see it's a beam action, a simple beam action you can see. So what we can say that in the lower 1 meter of this of the water tank, you can say it is the cantilever action is more prominent, and the upper portion you can assume to have the beam action or the flexure action as more prominent. Okay, so we will divide this whole water, the high depth of the water tank, into two parts. The first above above 1 meter from the bottom, this part. So this part will be designed as a beam action or flexure, or the moments will be taken care of basically, and it will be designed as like beam. We have designed beams, and the lower 1 meter portion will be from basically we will look into the cantilever action, and then we will find out the moment, and we will design this particular portion. Okay, so now considering the a level 1 meter above the floor, so we are considering 1 meter above the floor just now what I have shown you. So this portion, so this is 1 meter. Water pressure at this level, so if you see the water pressure is triangular. So at this level, so total depth is 3 meters, so it will be 2 meter and this will be 1 meter. So what is the water pressure over here? So water pressure, the maximum water pressure will be rho into h. So rho is the, or w is the unit weight of water, and depth is 2 meter. So this is the pressure per unit area. Then bending moment per meter height at this level at the corner. So if we're looking at the corner, the equation for the corner is WL square by 12, as well as for mid span it is WL square by 16. So if we're considering the corner, then it becomes P. P becomes this one. This is 19.62. This represent the W. Then L effective square into by 12, and that will give you this moment. So this moment is basically kilonewton meter per meter, because this moment is acting per unit depth. So per unit depth. So if you consider small strips, if you consider small strips, then this is the moment. Suppose if you consider this strip, then this is the moment. The moments are different, so if you can divide the whole system into small strips, so that is why the moments per unit meter. So it is per unit depth, okay, or per unit height of the corner. So you have found out to be M1. So I have denoted it as M1 end underscore end. So it will represent the moment per meter depth in the end section above 1 meter from the base. Okay. Then you can find out what is the moment at the mid span, and the equation is WL square by 16. What I have we have already told you. So the value becomes 34.445. Okay, now let us look at how to calculate the pull on the wall. So in the previous class also I have discussed with you that in a rectangular water tank, along with the moment due to water, there will be a pull in the walls that you will feel. So in the rectangular water tank, as you can see that as these two walls are also experiencing certain water pressure, and because of this there will be a pull at the two ends of this wall. Okay, so as we are basically designing the 5 meter wall, so what is the pull, what will be the pull value? The pull value you can see here as PW1 into B by 2. So B is the width, that is 3 meter. So P into 3 by 2, that is 29.43. So design, now we will go for design of the corners. So let us assuming that providing a clear cover of 25 mm as well as using 16 mm dia bars, the effective depth can be calculated as T thickness minus 25 minus 16 by 2, and which in turn will give you 267 mm. Okay. Now the effective bending moment at the corner per meter height, the effective bending moment, what is that? So basically you can see if I show you a particular cross section of a wall, suppose this is a small strip of the wall, just like a beam. Now as you can see that a moment is being developed, right? So because of the moment, it will try to deflect in this direction, right? So it is trying to deflect. So it is trying to deflect, and also there is also tension in the wall. Okay, so what is the effective moment? That you already know that when there is a tension, and it counteract the moment that is acting at the particular member. Just the example that I have given in the previous class, just assume a rope which is tied at the two post at the two end, and which is used for drying of clothes. So if you put some clothes over here, then obviously what will happen, that the wire will sag, right? And if you want to remove the sagging, what you will do, you will just pull the two post the other side, so that the tension will develop at the cable, and it will again come to its original shape. So this is how actually the pull or the tension acts in a beam. So when there is a pull, so it will actually encounter the moment, or it will reduce the moment. So that same effect we are going to consider over here. So what is the effective moment? So which is denoted by M1E underscore effective is equal to what is the moment that is acting that we have already calculated at the end, it is WL square by 12. Then we will subtract the moment developed because of the tension. So that will be what? That will be T1 into T minus T wall by 2. That means basically if this is a section and if this is the effective depth, so suppose that as the reinforcement, this is the effective depth and this is the T wall. So I just want to find out what is the distance, because we can assume that the tension will be basically taken by the reinforcement. So we will think that the tension is going to act at this particular point at the center of the reinforcement. So I just need to find out what is the distance of the reinforcement from the center of the section, and that will be d minus t wall by 2. That means I will subtract d minus this value, I will subtract this portion, I will subtract, and I will get this particular depth. So this is what I want to multiply with the tension. The tension force is acting at this particular point, so T into this lever arm, that will give you the moment, and that will encounter the applied or the acting moment because of the water. So T1 will into D minus T wall by 2, and that will give you a 42.484 kilonewton meter per meter. So everything is in per meter depth. Okay, so this is how you can find out the effective moment, and we have to design for effective moment as well as the tension, just like we did in the last class. Now the steel, the process of finding out the steel is similar to that of last class. So as we are assuming M25 for M25 concrete, if you refer to table 4, it is table 2, it is 8.5 MPa, and FST is 130 for all HYSD bars, and we have assumed that a thickness of a strip of 1 meter, so B is 1000 mm. Now if you find out mu by bd square, you convert it to in terms of newton per mm square per meter. So everything is in per meter. So you just forget about this and just remember that it is everything that we are calculating, it is in per meter terms, per meter depth. So first calculate mu by bd square, and then you can refer to the SP16 table 70. From this you can find out for sigma ST value is equal to 130, and mu by bd square value, and correspondingly you can find out what is the percentage of steel. And for our case, as mu by bd square value is 0.596, so here you can see for 596 is not there, but just above that value we have 0.612, that is 0.52%. So we are going to take as percentage of steel as 0.52%. So if you see, the percentage of steel is 0.52% per meter depth. So area of the steel, you can find out, this is the area of the steel, B into, here B is 1000 mm. Okay, and this is the area of the reinforcement per meter depth. Then steel for pull, now you can see that we have a moment, that is okay, that is fine, but that is a tension, right, that we have assumed to be taken by the steel. So what will be the tension, how much of amount of steel that will be required? T by sigma ST. Sigma ST is 130 here, and that will give you 226.385 mm² per meter. And if you add this to, you will get the total area of the steel, which is 1.786 into 10 to the power 3 mm² per meter. And if you want to find the spacing, you can find out by the equation, that is area of the cross section area of the bar into 1000 by the area of the steel provided, or the required, is equal to 112.52 mm. So let us provide 16 mm bar at 100 mm center to center. Now think about this, where is this particular moment acting? So we are talking about the end, right? So if I see, suppose this is the 3D view of the wall or the water tank. So as the water is being applied, so the whole wall will deflect something like this, right? Will try to deflect something like this. That means at the in moment that we are calculating, so this reinforcement, this moment that we are calculating, so reinforcement will be along this side. So reinforcement will be along this side. This reinforcement that we are calculating, this will be along this side. And it has been found that along this side, the spacing should be 110 mm center to center, 100 mm center to center. Okay, so we will see how to give the reinforcement, but one thing that you need to take care that this reinforcement along will be along this side. Okay, along this side, this kind of reinforcement you will see, because then only it will be able to take this deflection, right? Now going to the design for midsection, midspan, again you calculate the what is the effective moment at the midspan. Same equation, it is 31.02. I find out mu by vd square, then find out percentage of steel from the table 70 of SP16, find out area of steel, then also find out area of steel for pool, and then you can find out the total area of steel and the spacing. The spacing is found to be 140 mm center to center. Okay, so we will see the about detailing of the reinforcement, we will see that, but first then now let's go to the because this all this design is up to 2 meter height, right? Or the portion of the water tank which is above 1 meter from the bottom, right? Above 1 meter. So we are only designing this part. So we are still remaining with this part, so we have to design. So we have assumed that this part is going to act as a cantilever, right? So let's go for that. So in this case, what we will assume that suppose this is the wall, this is the 1 meter portion, and this is the water. So we will assume that here it is become zero, and the water pressure distribution is something like this. To consider the maximum effect of the water, so we'll assume that the water pressure distribution is something like this. Okay, that means this is zero, this is 0 meter, and this is 3 meter. So this pressure will be what? The unit weight of water into 3 meter, right? So this will be the pressure over here. Unit weight into 3 unit weight into 3 meter, right? And there it will be zero, and weightless force will act at a distance one third from the base. So this distribution we are going to use, this distribution we are going to use. So let's see that here you can see the maximum pressure at the bottom. It is W water into 3 meter, that is 29.43 kilonewton per meter square. The maximum pressure force at the bottom 1 meter is half into, because that same distribution, I told you that we are going to assume this distribution, this 1 meter height, this one. This is suppose 3 meter, this is 2 meter, this is 0. So this is 1 meter the height. So 0.5 half into base into hypotenuse. So this is the base and this is the hypotenuse is 1 meter. So this is the pressure. Then this force is going to act to the 1/3 from the base. So this is 1/3. This is the force, and that force value this is the force value basically. This is the area of this particular triangle. Then what is the moment that will act? The force into distance of what? Distance 1/3 from the base. So 1/3 meter, so it becomes 4.905 kilonewton meter per meter. You can see this value is very less value. So as this value is very less, you can see that obviously it will go for minimum steel design. Okay, because if you find out mu by vd square, it will give you a very less value, 0.067. So you will not find it in the table of table 70 of SP16. So we are going to go for the minimum steel. So minimum steel requirement is 0.3% as per IS 3370 part 2. Okay, so we are going to give 0.3%. So 0.3 of the total gross cross sectional area. So B into T wall is 900 mm square. So find out the spacing. It is 89. Or here we are changing the means the diameter of the bar. It's, we are using 10 mm bar. So it is 87.55. So you can see overall we can use 80 mm. Okay, and where this bar will be? So we are talking about the cantilever action here. So if we are talking about the cantilever action, that means suppose this is one wall of the water tank. So we are talking about the cantilever action, that means the wall will deflect, the new wall position will be somewhere here, right? So there will be cantilever action. So if there is cantilever action, the reinforcement will be from top to bottom like this. The reinforcement will be from top to bottom, or this is the, these are the actually the vertical reinforcement. So in the vertical reinforcement we are using 10 tor at direct 80 center to center. But the thing is, you can provide the reinforcements are provided on both the side of the wall. Is basically if it is 150 mm and all, we can give one layer, but as the depth is very large, we can go for larger, we can go for giving the reinforcement to the two sides. So if you provide the same reinforcement on two sides, the spacing will be double, right? If you provide the spacing reinforcement only one side, the spacing is 80, but if I provide the same reinforcement on both the sides, the reinforcement will be, the spacing will be double. So that will be 160 mm center to center. So that is what we have provided, 160 mm center to center for vertical reinforcement. Then both the slab and for about the base slab, so we are just this is just an that is like in for the base slab there is no such design. Only the thing is that the water leakage would not be there and all. So we are giving a 240 mm thickness thick concrete cover, as and we are providing two layers or two meshes of reinforcement at top and base, and which are 10 mm dia and with a spacing of 200 mm center to center. So we know the limit is 300 mm center to center, so we are going for 200 mm center to center. So this is what as per design we have found out. So if you want to see how the drawing will look like, so you can see over here I just made a PDF of an AutoCAD file. So see here, this is the is a cross section, basically top view. So this is inner to inner dimension is 3000 and outer to outer is 3600, right? So we have basically the vertical reinforcement as well as horizontal reinforcements over here. The vertical reinforcement, just now we have discussed that it will be taken care of by that cantilever action, and we have found that it should be, if I provide, if we provide the reinforcement in both the side, the spacing is 160 mm center to center, 10 mm diameter bars if you are using. So these are the vertical reinforcements with a 10 mm dia, 160 mm center to center. It should be sufficient to take that particular cantilever action of the water. And the horizontal reinforcements are basically considering the end moment and mid-span moment as well. So you can see the reinforcements are provided on both the surface of the water of the wall. So these are the reinforcement profile or bar bending schedule you can see. So here the one bar will go from this side to this side, so it will look like this. You can provide in the outer side, then this bar you will provide in the inside, so it will just connect. And at the corner you will provide a bar bending schedule something like this. So the spacing of all these bars are 140 center to center. And if you remember, we have used in our design that at the end section we need to provide a spacing of 110 mm center to center for 16 tor bar, right? And at the mid span it is I think 140 mm center to center 16 dia at the mid span. This is at the mid span. Okay, so at the mid span it is okay, fine. 140 mm center to center, these bars are provided, at 120 over center. So this will be taken care of. But what about this 110? So we will be will not be provided 110, but we will take the half, because we will provide some another bar in between, and that another bar will be some this one. So it will be provided at all the corners. So it will be provided in between the bars which are provided like this. Okay, so finally, the if you want to see the side view of the wall, say suppose 3 meter height and 3 meter dimension wall, then you can see at the end. So let me zoom it over here. So you can see this is the reinforcement here. These are the bars which has a bar bending schedule, something like this. Okay, and these are the bars which are provided at 140 mm center to center. Okay, these are the bars which are provided at 140, and this bar is nothing but this one, this bar, and these are also provided 140 mm center to center, because this bar and this bar and this bar, these are 140 mm center to center. So which are provided in between the long wire. So it will, the finally the spacing at the end becomes 70 mm center to center. So we are taking care of our condition that it should be 110, but for our perspective, from the construction perspective, that is not possible for us. So we are providing 70 mm center to center, which is also safe. Okay, so like this, reinforcement detailing should be done for this water tank. So with this, I would like to conclude today's class. Thank you.